Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be doing a Q&A answering May's question, can you show how you made the dies, which was asked on our how to round corners and edges in Sketchup, and we're going to dive into that right after the intro. Whenever I start modeling off of an existing object, I always Google to see if there is anything that I can use as a reference image. So I did that and I downloaded an image that I found. And this is actually like an awesome image. I want to make sure that I do this just as an image. Import that. And right now the scale doesn't matter too much. The one thing you want to make sure of is that you don't import too small. Or what will happen is it'll start to get sort of messed up because Sketchup doesn't like modeling things that are really tiny. So I would say model larger than you think you need or that you want to go, and then just scale it back afterwards. So the first thing that you sort of notice is that there's a relationship of all of these to each other. So there's a center circle here. And some of these have the center circle, and some of them don't. But they're sort of like this grid layout. So if you imagine there's six here, but you could have nine little dots. So I just want to make sure that when we do this, everything is equally spaced. So I'm going to use this six as a reference for how far everything should be spaced apart. And then I can use these little like three quarters views. To sort of figure out which side goes next to which, so we can use that. So this is a good image from that. I'm not gonna be using this like exact image to reconstruct the file or like to photo match, but we're gonna go to camera and then parallel projection. We're just gonna get a flat straight on view here. And R for the rectangle tool. And then draw a rectangle over this. Now you can see there's like this little dashed line. That's the golden section. So it basically means that the top part of the rectangle here is proportional to the length, this here. So it's like this looks like it's probably 2-to-1 ratio. What we're going to do is just make a rectangle, a square. I'm going to hit shift to lock to that axis and roughly draw this in so that it is here. Now it's hard to sort of see what's going on. So I'm going to hit B to bring up the paint bucket tool. I'm going to just give this a color, edit it, and turn down the opacity so I can sort of see what's going on. Now I'm going to assume that the center circle is actually in the center. Directly in the center. So what I'm going to start with is just to sort of eyeball where this goes. You want to make sure that if you can, whenever you're drawing a circle, lock to a particular axis. Draw all your circles in that direction. It just makes it easier in the future. So it looks about right. I didn't pick the exact center, but you can see I'm extending a little bit at the top and cut in a little bit at the bottom. Just try to like average that. Okay, so there we go there. Select the center and move it to the midpoint. Okay. Now these are going to be equidistant, right? So I'm going to select this guy. That looks close. Select this middle guy, hitting M for move. That's what I did before as well. Select that top point. And move it down that same distance. Okay, so now I have three circles. And this is sort of just making my template. Now I'm gonna assume, let's look. Do we have any? I guess there aren't any. There aren't any faces where you can like reference the two. I'm gonna assume that these might be like the same I'm just trying to get the center here. Sometimes it's hard to get to the center, but because we use the red axis here, it's fine. Let's see what this looks like if we just rotate it 90. Looks pretty spot on if you ask me. So this just gives us a reference. Let me just draw one of these segments to fill that in. Okay. Let's go back. Our camera's gotten a little bit wonky. So I'm going to select these two. Copy that over. And then do the same thing here. I don't need this line anymore. Select that. Move over. Okay. So this is basically our foundation for all of these. These are all equidistant from each other. So this distance here is equal to this, and that's just what I did. But this serves as a template for how we can do the rest of the model. So I'm going to hit the paint bucket tool, and what I will do here is paint this what are you going to do, like an off-white? Let's start with white, then edit it, make it a little bit with the color wheel. There we go. Okay, so we're going to start by making this a group. Copy this off to the side. Rotate, so I hit the M and then Control to copy. Now make sure I type in that. Copy this off to the side, rotate. Let's go 180 here. Money. Okay. Here. And then just flip this. Where's our axis? That's the green direction. All right, let's just try. We're just gonna rotate this then. I'm not sure exactly what's going on there. 180. Okay. So now we have something that doesn't look anything like a die. we're gonna get there, I promise. The next thing that we're gonna do is we are going to make the I don't know what you would call them, like these little indents. Because right now we have the circles, but the indents just aren't there. And the way that a die works is like there's just a little bit of recess. And it's hard to do that in SketchUp normally. So what we're going to be using is a plugin. And the plugin is this guy, the soap skin plugin. So I'm going to leave this a group, right? Select here, come into the middle, generate my circle, copy this off to the side, select this, generate soap skin. It's going to basically turn that into a grid, kind of. So, cool. Give me this, and then I'm going to generate a soap bubble, and now it's asking me for the pressure, so I'm going to hit 20, just see how that looks, if it did anything. Let's try 100, it's very subtle, so let's try negative 1000. There you go. That's doing something. So that looks okay. I'm just going to hit enter. And then delete that middle circle. So I have like this indent. Right? Now the way that I'm going to do this is make this like an off black. Okay. Now I have this on the red axis. So let's use our reference image. We'll do 6 on top. Rotate this 90 90 degrees. There we go. So let's do 6 here. 1, 2 times 2. Then I can just delete these middle guys and then delete these white circles. So there's 6. This yellow is really too yellow. There we go. That's better. Much better. Okay, so let's say there's 2 here. Delete that. And then right here what I'm doing is for the circles I don't want, I'm selecting the edge. And for the ones that I do want, I am selecting the face itself. Copy this off to the side. Q for rotate. Rotate this 90. And again, because of the way that we modeled that circle using the axis, it makes it super easy for us to just copy that and place it exactly where we want it to be. There's no question about is this in the right spot, because we made it easy on ourselves. Go into this group, delete these 3 faces. Okay. So let's try to figure out where these are gonna go. 3, 2, 3. I can't quite figure this out. I'm sure you guys can figure it out. I'm not gonna spend the time to try to figure this out right now. I'm just gonna say 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 6 and 5 are on opposite sides. How about that? That might be how it's done. Two, three, four, and I'm just going to delete this image because I don't need it anymore. 1, 2, oh, we're doing 1 here. Right? And then 5 on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? I didn't want 180. Sorry, 90. Just make sure you're in the right direction there, that you didn't rotate it to be the other way when you copy it. Convex instead of concave. Whoops. Looks like we... There we go. Come down. Copy both of these. So there we go. Now, just like you can see all these lines, if you don't want to see them, just turn off the edges. Alternatively, you could hide them. So if I should have made this a group because they're all the same, or a component since they're all the same, but you can come in here and not hide all the faces, but you can come in and select these lines and hide them. And that would make it so that you don't see them. And then the last thing, since these are all groups, if you want to do the, you can look at the other video that I made for how to round them. This, I'm just going to explode them. So I have that whole thing. Choose round. 0.5, yeah. Looks like it might not be enough. Let's try 1 inch. There we go. So there you go. That's how you model the dies in SketchUp. If you thought this video was helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.